Good evening, my friends. This is Fayaz, and you're watching Fuzz Rides. And as promised yesterday, we were supposed to actually go ahead and do a Q&A session. So let's do it today. So I have quite a few questions from all of you guys, and I'm going to go ahead and read all of them out for you, and do whatever I possibly can to ensure that you get the right answer. So let's start with the questions that were posted in Facebook. Okay, so the first question is from Tarun Mishra, and he says, Fuzz Rides, can you please tell me what vlogging camera do you use in on your helmet? So that is the question from Tarun. So Tarun, the camera that I use is SJ Cam, and it is SJ 5000 Plus. In matter of fact, I have it right now. Let me just show it to you. Okay. This is the camera. Let me just focus it. So this is the camera that I use for vlogging, and it's got a display over here, and it records in 4K, not really 4K, rather 2K to be precise, and 4K at 15 frames per second, though the specifications show that 4K recording in 30 frames per second, that doesn't actually do it. So anyways, I don't really use 4K. I use 1080p at 60 frames per second. So that is what I use on this camera. So that is your question's answer. So the next question is on the Facebook page that I got was from Manas Mazumdar. So the question goes something like this. I have no experience in riding bikes. I want to buy my first bike next year. I have set my eyes on 300cc category. Is it advisable to buy 300cc bikes for a newbie like me? I can drive though. The reason I want a 300cc is because I want to move on to 600 and 800cc class as soon as possible. Also, which bike would you advise? Yamaha R3, BMW G310R, Ninja 300, and a little bit of highway touring and city riding. So Manas, here is what I have for you. If you're looking for comfort, little bit of power, and a little bit of touring, I would always suggest you to go for Kawasaki Ninja 300, because that is an overall a very good package to go with. And besides Ninja 300, even the R3 is really a smooth bike, though it is a little bit on an expensive side. It's a really smooth bike. I have ridden it quite a few times, and on the highway as well, it is pretty smooth, a good decent performance from the bike, and it sounds really good. However, Ninja 300 doesn't really sound that good compared to that of Yamaha R3. BMW G310R, well, I don't really know, because I haven't really ridden it yet. But once I ride it, I know exactly, I would be able to actually, you know, let you guys know also. So the first question that you posted was, I want to buy my first bike, and is it advisable to buy a 300cc bike for a newbie? No problem. You can start with even a 600cc, but don't go for the R version of anything. 300cc would be a perfectly good bike to begin with, even a 250cc or even below, because these bikes are not that powerful when it's compared with sports bikes or a race bike or something, and it is manageable. It's not like you can't really ride much. So that is what my advice would be. Go with a 300, probably a Ninja 300 or a Yamaha R3. They both are really good bikes. Go with any one of them, whatever suits your requirement. And I hope that answers your question. So let's move on to the next one. So the next question posted on our Facebook page, Azar Vlogs has posted. So I don't know what your real name is. Azar, I'll just call you Azar. Hey, hope you're doing well. Please suggest me cheap and best jacket. Well, Azar, to begin with, there are quite a few jackets, quite a few companies which are actually making jackets these days, a lot of Indian companies rather. And to name a few, I would suggest go ahead and check out a brand called Cramster. They are actually located in Bangalore, I guess. Yeah, they are located in Bangalore. So Azar, first thing you need to understand is that what kind of jacket do you want? Do you want a mesh jacket? Do you want for touring? Do you want it for daily use, or do you want a racing jacket, or what exactly do you want? Those are the kind of questions that you need to ask yourself first. Once you know exactly what you want to go for, then you can go ahead and decide which jacket to buy. Decide for yourself. I can only guide you through. So first you need to understand is what kind of jacket you want to buy. Second, do you want to go for a leather or a mesh? Third, probably the brand, and you know, I would suggest Indian brand, but you have lots of other brands as well. But then other imported brands are quite expensive side, wherein Alpine Star would cost 14,000-15,000 compared to that of a Rhinox or a Biking Brotherhood jacket. Question is from Kalpesh Patole. I hope I am pronouncing it right. Kalpesh Patole. Forgive me if I'm wrong. So his question is, what are the legal issues with modifying a bike with a huge tank, other larger than life aesthetics like huge tire, body, etc. Like Vardhanji. So that is what he is asking the question. There is no legal issues. I had made a video on modification and laws that are around modification and stuff like that. So I would suggest you to go ahead and watch that video. And secondly, you can go ahead and put as big tire as you want. There is no law that stops you from that. About the body, you can go ahead and change it as per RTO rules, because if you change the color of the motorcycle, you have to actually ensure that you let the authorities know about it. As far as the lighting and everything is concerned, there are quite a few things that you need to actually check it out, I guess. That video answers all the questions, so I'll just put the information about the video over here. So you can just go ahead and check that out. Now we have another question from Jabir Malik. His question is, bhai, I am planning to do Ladakh. Could you please guide me which is the best time to visit? Which will be the best route to take from Mumbai? So, Jabir, the best time to go to Ladakh is between May, middle of May, or starting of June, all the way till September mid. So you can go to Ladakh during that time. During winters, the roads are really usually closed because of snow, and you can't really access Ladakh through roads. You have to go through flight. Best route to take would be from Mumbai to Ajmer, then Jaipur, then Delhi. From Delhi, go to Chandigarh. From Chandigarh to Manali. From Manali to Keelong. Keelong to Sarchu. Sarchu to Pang. Pang to Upshi. Upshi to Leh. That would be your my preferred route. But then there is another easy way as well, wherein you go all the way to Chandigarh. From Chandigarh, you go to Srinagar. From Srinagar, you go to Kargil. Kargil to Leh as well, which is the easier route. So these are the two optional routes for you over the road. So it's up to you, whatever you want. I mean, whatever is comfortable for you. And if you want, I can actually go ahead and probably, you know, make a proper video on how to reach there as well. So that was the question. Well, the next question is from Ansh Yadav. How do you edit your videos? So I use Adobe Premiere Pro to edit my videos, the 2016 version, which is a paid version, by the way. Before that, I didn't really use any editing software other than Windows Movie Maker, which was way back, somewhere around about 8 years back when I was in YouTube initially. So at that time, I used to use Windows Movie Maker, which was much easier. I use Adobe After Effects and also Adobe Premiere Pro. So these are the two softwares that I use for my videos. Now, how do I edit the videos? I guess I don't know how do I actually tell you how to edit. There are lots of tutorials out there. You can go ahead and check them out. If in case you really want to learn from me, you have to actually let me know so that I can actually edit one short clip and give you a proper tutorial. How do you cut, copy, paste everything and stuff like that? How do you match the video with the song or your audio or anything as such? So that might take a while. So you have to actually go ahead and comment below so that I also know what exactly are you actually looking for. The next question is from Tridev Chaudhary. So he says, can you make a video on accessories which are available in Hyderabad? What kind of accessories? I mean, kaun sa accessories bhai? Ye bhi mention kar do. I mean, I'm pretty sure that you want to know about bike accessories, but what kind of accessories is the first question. That is, do you want to know about the clothing, or do you want to know about the electronics, or do you want to know about the bike accessories such as exhaust, paint or something like that? I don't know. I mean, please be specific so that I can actually go ahead and give you a right answer. Probably you can go ahead and write a detailed question down in the comments so that I can answer you correctly. Okay, now to the YouTube questions. Those were all the Facebook questions till now. The next question is from Manoj Malkari. I hope I am pronouncing it correctly. That is Manoj Malkari. How do you charge your camera as you use to vlog continuously? Okay. When I'm actually touring, I record the entire tour. Like, for example, if I'm riding my bike for 12 hours or 10 hours or 15 hours, 20 hours, I'll record the entire journey throughout. One camera is always dedicated to, you know, record 24 hours a day or whatever. The other camera is used on my chin mount in order to actually go ahead and record whatever I am looking at. How do I charge? Well, I use this, let me just focus it. This is the Bolt charger that I use. So this I bought it for like 1700 or 1800 or so. So I use this charger. Now for some odd reason, I did a tour recently with one of my friends. I went to Calcutta, and while on the way, this charger's cable actually burnt, and because of some kind of a heating issue or something like that, I don't know how did it burn. So that does not come under warranty, so I'm just trying to figure out how do I get another cable. So to be very honest, I like this charger, but the cables along with this they are not really that good, so I wouldn't really suggest you one at this point. There are all other kinds of mobile chargers that you can actually charge your camera, your phone and stuff like that. So you can go ahead and check it out on eBay and Amazon. You probably might find quite a few. So have a look at them. The one that I use is this one. So I'm going to buy another one, by the way. So let's see how that goes. The next question in YouTube was, thank you, First Brother. So do as you promised me. Okay, what did I promise? Can you suggest which bike is good, Classic or Himalayan? As I am middle class person, and this question is posted by Angad Rane. So Angad, two totally different bikes, Royal Enfield Classic and Royal Enfield Himalayan. One is meant for touring and off-roading. The other is absolutely classy motorcycle. I wouldn't really suggest you neither of these bikes, because you really need a good, you need to know exactly what you want to go for. Himalayan is a good bike, decent bike, but by far the worst product ever by Royal Enfield, because the amount of time they have spent in marketing the product and ensuring that people like the product, if they would have put that in quality testing or something like that, in that way they could have actually made a much reliable, much better finished bike. Royal Enfield Himalayan is not up to the mark. It's somewhere over here in Royal Enfield. And Classic is right over there. Classic is a really good bike overall. Good, decent performance, good mileage, good top speed. It's an attention grabber right away. And Royal Enfield always has lots of customizable parts. You can always go ahead and opt all of them. So I hope that answers your question, Angad. Last but not the least, the question posted by one of my subscribers from Arunachal Pradesh. His name is Siddharth Barua. Hi bro, मेरा एक question है आपसे. मुझे एक बाइक लेना है 1.5 लाख का, 1.5 लाख के अंदर. तो KTM छोड़ के और कौन सी बाइक लूँ? सो बेसिकली अंगद इज आस्किंग विद इन 1.5 लाख रुपी रेंज विच बाइक वुड बी रियली गुड फॉर हिम, एंड ऑल्सो ही वॉन्ट्स टू डू अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ टोरिंग अदर देन KTM. पहली बात, सिद्धार्थ जी, KTM टोरिंग के लिए नहीं बनी. KTM ड्यूक स्ट्रीट बाइक है. पहली बात तो KTM ड्यूक जो है वो है स्ट्रीट बाइक आपकी, और दूसरी बात KTM RC जो है वो है स्पोर्ट्स बाइक. ये दोनों टोरिंग के लिए नहीं है, पहली बात. दूसरी बात, अगर आपको टोरिंग के लिए ही लेना है तो आप 1.5 लाख के अंदर, मेरा सजेशन ये होगा कि आप बजाज का डोमिनर देख लें, डोमिनर 400, विच इज़ प्रेटी गुड बाइक, डिसेंट बाइक. और एल्स आप ये भी देख सकते हैं कि हाँ भाई 1.5 लाख के अंदर क्या क्या मिल रहा है आपको. पहली बात तो आपकी एक्चुअल रिक्वायरमेंट क्या है, कि आप ज़्यादा सिटी में चलाते हैं या हाईवे पे चलाते हैं, ये दोनों में एक. दूसरी बात, आप लुक्स को प्रेफर करते हैं या क्या करते हैं, इन द सेंस आप क्या चाहते हैं अपनी बाइक से, ये बताएं आप हमें, तो हम आपको प्रॉपरली आंसर भी कर पाएंगे कि एक्चुअली में आपको क्या चाहिए, व्हाट सूट्स यू द बेस्ट. KTM तो भूल ही जाओ, KTM टोरिंग के लिए नहीं बनी, पहली बात. और आखिरी बात वही है, डोमिनर इज अ प्रेटी गुड टूरर. सो डोमिनर से ज़्यादा स्मूथ मक्खन वाली बाइक आज तक बजाज ने क्रिएट ही नहीं किया. तो आप जाके डोमिनर खरीद लें अगर आपको पसंद है तो. other than Dominar, I don't think there is any other bike which is actually meant for touring. However, my response to this would be, अगर आपके अंदर will है, you can take any bike anywhere without having any issues. I hope I was able to answer all your questions and I was able to be of some little bit of assistance to all of you guys. And any other questions that you might have, please feel free to ask me, and I don't mind going ahead and answering all of them. And don't think that I'll not be answering them, I will. But कुछ questions ऐसे होते हैं जिसको आपको in the sense you need to actually show it to you rather than actually just talking about it. I would rather prefer that because there are quite a few questions which I got. Like for example, one of my subscribers, his name is Sumit Rocks. He asked, Fuzz Rides, please do a video on your riding kit and accessories. Now I want to actually go ahead and do a video on both of them. In fact, I have already done it. I have uploaded it, but I have scheduled it for later on. So Sumit, I have heard your question and I have already made a video for it. Probably you will get your questions answered on that video. So hopefully that'll be more than sufficient enough. In case you have any further queries or anything that you want to understand from me, please feel free to ask that question and write it at the comments below so that I can actually go ahead and do such videos in the future as well. I am more of a tourer and a biker than anything else. So anything to do with touring, biking, technology with regards to bikes, how things work or work on a bike, all these things you can go ahead and ask me and I'll be more than happy to actually help you guys out. Hopefully this video has been helpful to all of you guys, and I appreciate all of your time and patience that you have showed me in specific, and all the love that you have actually showed me till now. I'm really grateful to have really good subscribers like you, and hopefully I would love to meet all of you in person. Please do give it a like if you liked it, and do subscribe if you have not subscribed yet, and please share this video with all your friends and like-minded people who would love to actually know about riding overall. And it was an amazing experience sharing my experiences with you guys, and any question in the future will be answered, hopefully. Take care guys, have fun, bye bye.